Trump holds hands with beaming Melania as they land back in the U.S. following his home run foreign trip, but returns to face Russia's scandal which has enveloped son-in-law Jared Kushner. President Donald Trump returned home to the White House on Saturday after branding his first international tour through the Middle East and Europe a home run. Trump, wearing a navy suit with a red tie, descended from Air Force One with First Lady Melania Trump, who paired a mint-green cardigan with cropped white trousers. To the White House, Trump's first trip abroad was an embodiment of the promises he made as a candidate to put America's interests first and break through the guardrails that have long defined U.S. foreign policy. But Trump is returning to simmering investigations into his associates' ties to Russia, which have reached his inner circle after son-in-law and White House advisor Jared Kushner was named a person of interest in an FBI probe. Kushner spoke with Ambassador Sergei Kislyak and proposed a secret back channel between the Kremlin and Trump's transition team during a December meeting, according to a bombshell report in The Washington Post. Gary Cohen, Trump economic aide, said during a press conference in Italy, "We are not going to comment on Jared." Upon Trump's return, however, the White House is now trying to contain the scandal by expanding the president's legal team while testing new communications strategies that would advance the administration's agenda while limiting opportunities to be confronted about damaging stories, according to the New York Times. As he dashed through the Middle East and Europe, Donald Trump looked like a conventional American leader abroad. He solemnly laid a wreath at a Holocaust memorial in Jerusalem, had an audience with the Pope at the Vatican and stood center stage with Western allies at the annual summits that dominate the diplomatic calendar. But when Trump spoke, he sounded like anything but a typical U.S. president. On his first overseas tour, the new president made no attempt to publicly promote democracy and human rights in Saudi Arabia, instead declaring that he wasn't there to lecture. In Israel and the West Bank, he pointedly did not back America's long-standing support for a two-state solution to the intractable peace process. And in the heart of Europe, Trump berated NATO allies over their financial commitments and would not explicitly endorse the one-for-all, all-for-one defense doctrine that has been the cornerstone of transatlantic security for decades. Trump boarded Air Force One on Saturday without having held a single news conference on the trip, a break in presidential precedent that allowed him to avoid tough questions. Instead, the White House hoped to let the images of Trump in statesmanlike settings tell the story of his first trip abroad, and perhaps ease questions about his preparedness for the delicate world of international diplomacy. At his final stop in Italy, Trump addressed an appreciative military crowd at the Naval Air Station Sigonella as they hooted and hollered at his pledges to eradicate terrorism and reassert America's global muscle. Saturday's speech was equal parts victory lap and campaign bluster. "The single greatest strength of our armed forces is you," he said, pointing outward. "You. All of you. The dedicated, really tough and really disciplined servicemen and women who bravely fight in our name. You not only know the pain of sacrifice, but you also know the tremendous rewards of military service, of being part of something much larger than even yourselves. You know what it means to be part of a military team in which men and women are bound together in a sacred covenant of trust to serve together, to sacrifice together and to fight together. And, by the way, to win together," the president added, returning to another campaign buzzword. Trump also boasted of his budget proposal's massive $54 billion enlargement of the Pentagon spending power, calling it an historic investment in defense spending. But Trump's return home Saturday night shifts attention back to the storm clouds of scandal hovering over the White House. In a briefing with reporters Saturday, White House officials shifted uncomfortably and refused to comment when asked about reports that Jared Kushner, Trump's son-in-law and senior advisor, tried to set up secret communications with Russia after the election. Kushner spoke with Ambassador Sergei Kislyak about creating a back channel to facilitate sensitive discussions aimed at exploring the incoming administration's options with Russia as it was developing its Syria policy, according to a person familiar with the discussions who spoke with the Associated Press. "The intent was to connect Michael Flynn, Trump's chief national security advisor at the time, with Russian military leaders," according to the AP source. Russia, a pivotal player in Syria, has backed Syrian President Bashar Assad, often at the expense of civilians during a long civil war. Kushner also had at least three previously undisclosed contacts with Kislyak both during and after the 2016 presidential campaign, Reuters reported. Kushner's attorney, Jamie Gorelick, said Kushner has no recollection of the calls as described. In an attempt to contain the scandal, the White House is looking to expand both a private team of lawyers, and hire additional support for White House counsel Dongan, according to the New York Times. Trump is also expected to meet with his private lawyers in Washington as early as Sunday. The White House is also approaching communications from a new angle, so the administration can speak directly to Trump supporters through campaign rallies, social media, or flattering interviews with hand-picked news organizations, The Times reported. That would likely lead to White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer taking on a less public role as the administration considers limiting daily briefings. Jared and Igor returned home from Rome on Thursday, with sources saying the couple will revisit the possibility of returning to private life in New York every 6 months as they have found it difficult to do as much as they originally hoped.